Hi, I'm Alex for Teach Like This, and this is a flipped classroom. No, really, this is a flipped classroom. And so is this. And this too. There's not one iconic flipped classroom. There's a variety of ways to do it, and it's up to you to make it work. But all flipped classrooms have these two things in common. First, the flipped classroom requires students to do what they normally did in the classroom at home. Secondly, it allows them to control the pace at which they learn information. In the traditional classroom model, students come to a place where there's a lecturer, the lecturer lectures and students take notes, then the students go home to try to do the problems that they're assigned. If the students have problems in the application side of their knowledge, there's nobody there to help them out. In the flipped classroom model, the lecturer records himself giving the lecture and assigns that for homework. The following day, students come to the classroom where they apply their knowledge, and if there's any interventions that the teacher needs to do, the teacher can help and assist however the students need. After the teacher has helped the majority of students, can assign the work for the day, and then target individual learners that need additional assistance. This one-on-one attention that the teacher can now provide is much more effective for struggling learners. Additionally, bright students or students that are absent a lot can work at a different pace. Bright students can work faster than they need to, and students that are absent a lot can catch up quicker. The flipped classroom model allows the learners to control the pace of the lectures. They can pause, rewind, or fast forward however they feel they need. That empowers the students and differentiates learning for a variety of students. To paraphrase one of my favorite quotes about a teacher that flipped his classroom, "I used to focus on the brightest kids because I wanted the lecture to go well and they were getting it. But now I focus on the students that need me the most." Some teachers have even taken the flipped classroom to the ultimate level and developed individualized curriculum for students. They have to watch this amount of lectures and perform this task, and when they're done with their task, they move on to the next set of lectures. This kind of pacing guarantees mastery in a unit. However, on the downside, where does that student make up that additional learning that they're required to have? One solution might be after-school learning or finishing up during summer school. Whatever the case, the lectures are available to them. Additionally, when parents hear that their student is required to listen to lectures online, they might initially think that their teacher is lazy. Another possible hurdle for this strategy is internet access. If a student doesn't have internet access at home, they need to find another way in order to get to those lessons. Obviously, these hurdles can be overcome with patience, creativity, and education. If you want to use this strategy, the data is on your side. That's all for this video. If you have additional questions, you can connect with me on Twitter, by email, or by commenting down below. And subscribe for weekly strategies in your newsfeed. I'm Alex, and that's Teach Like This. Thank you.